Hello my dear friends, welcome for today's video lecture of Ganit Pravinya. In today's lecture, we are going to solve the word problems, remaining word problems from the exercise 8. Okay, in earlier lecture, we have learned addition and subtraction of the fraction. Today, the word problems which are based on the concept of the fraction, we are going to solve it. Pay attention very carefully because those problems are, word problems are based on the concept of fraction. Okay, now see problem number 32. I am reading. You open your Xerox and put your finger in exercise, open exercise 8 and see the problem number 32. Put your finger when I am reading. Mother gave Prakash some sweet balls for 3 days hitchhike. Prakash ate 1/4 of them on the first day, 1/2 of them on the second day, and the leftover 3 balls on the third day. How many sweet balls did mother give Prakash? Once again, I am going to read. See here. Mother gave Prakash, her son, okay? Mother gave Prakash some sweet balls. Sweet balls means we can say sweet, okay? For 3 days hitchhike means traveling. For three days traveling, she gave some sweet balls to him, okay, to eat during the travel, okay. So it was 3 days hitchhike, 3 days travel. The Prakash ate 1/4 of the sweet balls on the first day. Total how many sweet balls mother gave to Prakash? Don't know. But that will be unknown, okay. So Prakash ate 1/4 of them, means what? He divided those sweet balls into 4 equal parts and one part he ate on the first day, that is 1/4, okay. On the second day he ate 1/2, means those total, 1/2 means 1/2, means the total sweet balls, if divided into 2 equal parts, out of 2 equal parts he ate 1 part, okay. And on the third day, the leftover 3 balls on the third day, that means what? After eating 1/4 sweet balls on the first day, 1/2 sweet balls on the second day, on the third day how many left sweet balls left? 3 sweet balls left, and those 3 sweet balls he ate on the third day. Then the question is, how many sweet balls did mother give Prakash? How many sweet balls did mother give Prakash? Now see, this is what a little confusing, but don't worry. The first, see the method also. Understand the method, understand the concept. Okay, when we will solve many problems like this, you will come to know. In case if you don't understand this problem, don't worry. When we will solve many problems, when we will practice many problems like this, then you will understand, okay? Then also try to understand. See now, mother gave Prakash some sweet balls. We don't know how many, okay? But those some sweet balls, means the sweet balls mother gave to Prakash, we will consider it one whole, okay? One whole. See you. Let the mother, sorry, see here, let's consider mother gave or sweet balls given by mother to Prakash. Okay, sweet balls given by mother to Prakash. Let's consider it one. One indicates one. One means what? She did not give one sweet ball to Prakash. Total sweet balls, whatever sweet balls are given to Prakash, we are considering one whole. ओके, वन मीन्स वन, वन इन के इन सेंस वन होल, ओके, सो दैट विल बी कंसिडर एज अ वन. ओके, नाउ प्रकाश एट, प्रकाश एट स्वीट बॉल्स ऑन द फर्स्ट डे, ऑन द फर्स्ट डे हाउ मेनी स्वीट बॉल्स ही एट, वन फोर्थ, वन फोर्थ. ओके, ऑन द सेकेंड डे he ate 1/2, and on the third day, on the third day he ate remaining 3 balls. Means this, the sweet balls he ate on the third day are not given in the form of fraction. The balls, sweet balls he ate on the third day are given actually how many balls were remain on the third day, and those balls he ate, that is 3 balls, 3 sweet balls. Okay, then total how many balls were given to the given to him by his mother. Okay, now what to do in this, there are many methods to find the answer. Okay, what we will do, we will add this, the sweet balls which are given on the first day and second day, they are given in the form of fraction, so we will add this. Then we will subtract this from the total which we have considered as a 1. Okay, we will subtract, then we will get the fraction, that will be the fractional form of the sweet balls he ate on the third day. There is that is also method. The easiest method I will tell you, very easy method. Okay, see, total sweet balls given by mother we have considered one whole, that one will be considered. Consider that this is one whole. We will go by figurical representation. It's very easy to understand by this method. Okay, see, one whole. Now, on first day he ate 1/4. Means what? These are total sweet balls. Okay, so on the first day he ate 1/4. Means what? He divided those total sweet balls into 4 equal parts. You know, denominator of any fraction indicates total equal parts. So he divided that sweet balls into 4 equal parts. 4 equal parts, and out of 4 equal parts he ate 1. That means 1 part. In that 1 part, how many sweet balls were there? Still we don't know. Okay. On the second day, he ate 1/2. 1/2 means what? Out of 2 equal parts, he ate 1. Now see, out of 2 equal parts means already we have divided this total sweet balls into 4 equal parts. So again, don't divide it into 2 equal parts. What to do in this case? Here denominator was 4. Denominator is 4. Okay, that means total equal parts we have considered here 4. Here there are 2 equal parts. So to avoid the confusion, what we will do, this denominator 2 we will convert into 4. Can we convert? Means we will find its equivalent fraction. Can we convert this into 4? We can. Yes, see, when we will multiply this 2 by 2, we will get 4. Now see, 2 multiply by 2, 4. So here in the denominator we have multiplied by 2. So in the numerator also we need to multiply by 2. So here we will get 2 ones are 2, 2 twos are 4. 1/2 and 2/4, it is same, okay, they are equivalent fraction. Why we have done like this? Because here in this fraction the denominator is 4, so here also we want, in this fraction also we want same denominator. For that we have found its equivalent fraction having denominator 4. Okay, so we got 1/2 is converted into 2/4. Now see, on the first day he divided all sweet balls into 4 equal parts, he ate 1. On the second day he ate 2/4. 2/4 means out of 4 he ate 2 parts. Now there are 4 parts, out of 4 parts he ate 2. So this one we will shed and this one. okay? This is possible when it is possible to find through figurical representation when the fractions which are given here, their denominator should be same. If denominators are not same, then we have to make the denominator same like this. Okay. Now remain on the, this is on the first day, these two parts eight on the second day. Now remain one only part on the third day. Okay. Now see, on the third day he ate three sweet balls. So see here, this one part means how many sweet balls? Three sweet balls. Now you understood, this one part is remain for third day, and on third day he ate three sweet balls. That means what, you know, this one part represent three sweet balls, 1/4 remain, one out of four equal part, one part remain for the third day, right? Sweet balls remain on the third day. How many? According to this figure, out of four equal parts, this one part remain. But already they have given on third day he ate how many sweet balls? Remaining three sweet balls. That means what? This one out of four means three sweet balls. Okay? One out of four means out of four equal parts, one part means three sweet balls. Then we have to find total. So total sweet balls is equal to total sweet balls is equal to total. Now see, one part means three sweet balls, then total how many parts are there? 1, 2, 3, and 4. That is 4 into 4 parts are there. So this one part indicates 3 balls, 3 balls, 3 balls, 3 balls. That is 4 into 3. That is 12 sweet balls. So mother gave 12 sweet balls to Prakash to eat during the hitchhike. Understood? Once again I repeat. I think many of you have not understood this. Once again see here. Remember the concept of fraction. Once again see, mother gave some sweet balls to Prakash to eat during hitchhike, during travel. On first day he ate 1/4, on the second day he ate 1/2, and on the third day he ate 3 sweet balls. Remaining 3 sweet balls means on the third day 3 sweet balls were left, so he ate that. Okay, so we have to find how many sweet balls were given by mother to him. Now let's consider sweet balls given by mother. 1 means one whole. Okay, one whole, which we have considered here one circle. Okay. Now on the first day he ate 1/4 means what? One whole means total sweet balls were divided into 4 equal parts and he ate one, this one. Then on the second day he ate 1/2. Now here denominator is 2, so we cannot shed here because that was already divided into 4 equal parts. So what is solution for that? We made denominator same here as here first. Okay, so here denominator was 2, we made it 4 by multiplying both numerator and denominator by 2. So we got here 2/4. That means on second day he ate 2/4 sweet balls. So we shared here 2 parts and 1 part remained for third day. So on the third day he ate 3 sweet balls. That means what, you know, this one part represent 3 sweet balls. So sweet balls remain on the third day 1/4. Okay. Is equal to 3 sweet balls. That means one part means 3 sweet balls. So total sweet balls are, to as you know, total parts are 4. So 4 multiplied by 3, that is 12 sweet balls are there or were given by mother. Okay. Next question number 33. All problems are like this only. And we are going to use same method in this way. We will draw that figure, and when the fractions which are given, we will make denominator same. If the denominator is not same, we will make denominator same of all fractions, and accordingly we will proceed. See now, question number 33. A pole buried in a lake has 2/5 of its height in the mud, 1/5 part in water, and the part above the water level is 2 meters long. What is the total length of the pole? There is one lake this way. This is water. Okay, and you know whenever you see, you know the lake. Okay, there is water and below water there is soil, wet soil, that is called mud. Okay, suppose this is mud. Okay, now in this lake, one pole is buried. That see, the pole is in this way. This is pole, it is buried in the water. Now see, a pole buried in a lake has 2/5 of its height in mud. 2/5 means what? Mud means this, from here to here. Okay, now see, height in mud, height of pole in mud, how much it is? 2/5. First we will write that height of pole in water, in water, how much it is? 1/5. And height of pole above water is, they have given here actually height, means they are not given in this in the form of fraction, 2 meters. Okay, this mud we need to increase. See, what is total height of the pole? What is total height of the pole? Now see here. From here to here there is mud, from here to here there is water level, and from here to here above the water level. Okay, now see, height of pole in mud is 2/5. 2/5 means the pole is divided into 5 equal parts. Let's divide the pole into 5 equal parts. 1, 2, 3, 4 and wait. 1, 2, here there is water. This is pole. Okay. Now it is divided into 5 equal parts. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Okay, now see, this is pole. From here to here it is divided into 5 equal parts. Out of 5 equal parts, 2 parts are in the mud. That means these two, 1 and 2. These 2 parts are in the mud. From here to here there is mud, right? So 2 parts of the pole are in the mud. Height of pole in the water 1/5 means what? Out of 5 equal parts. Here see, denominators of both the fractions are same, 5, 5. Here, denominators of both fractions were different. So, we made here denominator same. Now, here denominators are same. So, our half work is already done. Okay. Out of 5 equal parts, 2 parts were in the mud. That is this one and this second. Then, height of pole in the water, 1, 5. That means out of 5 equal parts, 1 part is there in the water, this one. Okay. We can give number 3. And height above the pole of water is 2 meter. Above them is from here to here. Height is 2 meter. Okay. Now you know that 2 meter means above the water level, how many parts of that pole is pole remain? 2 parts, right? Fourth one and fifth one. 2 parts. Understood? So the 2 parts which are above the water level, they represent what height? They represent 2 meter. Understood? So parts or height of pole above water is in the form of fraction, it is these 2 parts, right? That means 2 parts out of 5. But they have given actual height 2 meter. So these 2 parts means 2 meter. So 2 parts is equal to 2 meter. 2 parts is equal to this means 4th one and 5th one. These 2 parts means 2 meter height. Then such total height of the pole we have to find, no? So total height of the pole is equal to total height of the pole from, that means from here to here. Total how many parts are there? 5 parts. So 2 parts means 2 meter. Then 1 part means 1 meter. That means 5 parts means 5 meter. See, 2 parts means 2 meter. So 1 part means 1 meter. And 1 part means 1 meter, so 5 parts means 5 into 1, that is 5 meter. So the height of, total height of the pole is 5 meter. Understood? Understood this? Once again see, a pole is buried into the lake. Okay? Height of pole in mud. Mud means from here to here, it is 2/5. 2/5 means, if we divided pole into 5 equal parts, 2 parts are in the mud. Height of pole in water is 1/5, means out of 5 equal parts, 1 part is in the water and remaining 2 parts are above water. That the remaining 2 parts, height of pole above water is actually 2 meter, means this remaining 2 parts represent 2 meter. So 2 parts means 2 meter, then 1 part means 1 meter. So total 5 parts are there of that pole, so total height of the pole is equal to 5 parts, and 5 parts means actually how many height? 5 meter. Okay, because 1 meter means 1 part means 1 meter, so 5 parts means 5 into 1, 5 meter. As we have seen here, there are total 4 parts, 1 part means 3, 1 part means 1 part means 3 sweet balls. So total sweet balls are 4 parts, means 4 into 3, that is 12 sweet balls. Understood? Similarly here, 1 part means 1 meter, so 5 parts means 5 into 1, 5 meter. Okay. Now write these 2 word problems in your notebook. After that we will see remaining. All problems are like this only. You have to understand it, understand the concept. We have to make the denominator same and we have to proceed. Okay. Next. Next, problem number 34. Problem number 34. See here. A landowner divided his land into 3 parts and distributed it among his 3 sons. The eldest son got 5/16 of the land, The second son got 1/4 part of the land. How much part of the land did the youngest son get? Means what? There is one farmer or landowner, we can say. Landowner means who is having his own land. Okay. So he is having his three sons. So he want to divide that property into three parts. Okay. So what he did? He gave to his first son. How much property he gave? How much property he gave? 5/16. Means he made 16 equal part of that land, and he out of 16, 5 parts he gave to first son. To second son, he gave 1/4 part. Now here see. Here the total parts are 16, here total parts are given 4. So we have to convert this into 16. Let's convert immediately. 1/4, 1 out of 4, but out of 1 out of 4 equal part. Then out of 16 how many? That we have to find. So this 4, this denominator 4 we need to convert into 16. To convert 4 into 16, by which number we have to multiply? By 4. That is 4 for the 16. So here also we need to multiply by 4. Okay. So 4 ones are 4, 4 fours are 16. So this 1/4 is same as 4/16. To first son he gave 5 parts out of 16, then second son he gave 1 out of 4, that means 4 parts out of 16. And third son we have to find, right? How much part of the land did the youngest son got? Youngest means we can say third. Okay. So it's very easy. See here. For example, this is the total land, we can say. And here, as here denominator is 16, so let us divide this into 16 equal parts. Okay, 16 equal. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. What we have done, we have considered this is the whole land he has. Okay, and he divided his land into 16 equal parts. Out of 16, first son got 5 parts. So let us shed the 5 parts. This much property he gave to first son. Okay. Then second son. To second son he gave 1 part out of 4, but what we done, this 1/4 we converted into out of 16 he got 4. So there are 16 parts. Out of 16, second son got 4. We will shade in this way. Okay, 4 parts. 1, 2, 3, 4. You give to second son. And remaining got to third son, youngest son. So this much remaining land was given to youngest son. So how many parts youngest son got? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. This is 5/16. This is 4/16. And remain 7/16. Okay. So the youngest son, that is third son we have considered, the youngest son got 7/16 of the land. Okay, 7/16 of the land means 7 parts out of 16 equal parts of the land. Okay, this is our answer. क्वेश्चन नंबर 35. As soon as we will move forward, you will come to know this concept. It's very interesting and easy. You have to draw one figure which will indicate one hole and the fraction which are given here, according to which you have to divide that whole figure into equal parts and you have to shade for the given. Okay, it's very easy. See, question number 35, it is same. A man had three sons and one daughter, a daughter. A man had three sons and a daughter. He distributed his property among his children, giving 3/16 to the eldest son. Eldest son, he gave 3/16. He gave 3/16 to the eldest son. What is meaning of this? He made 16 equal parts of his properties, and out of 16 equal parts, 3 parts he gave to the eldest son. Then 5/16 to the youngest son. Youngest son, he gave 5/16. And the second son, means who was middle one, to second son he gave 5/16 again. Okay? And daughter, he was, you know, he was having one daughter. To daughter he gave rupees 15,000. See, there is given 5,000. It is printing, there is printing mistake. Instead of 5,000, write there 15,000. Okay. To daughter he gave rupees 15,000, means the property given to these three sons are given in the form of fraction, and property given to daughter are given in directly in the cash, means how much rupees he gave to daughter. These properties also in rupees. Okay, this property is also in rupees, but it is given in the form of fraction, and this property, the property given to his daughter is given in the form of rupees. So don't make confusion here. We will find that. What we have to find, what was the total value of the property, means if you add the property, this total property which he has distributed among his children, then what was the total value of his property? Total property we have to find. Now total property we have to find in the form of fraction, we have to find in the rupees. Okay, total property is equal to what? Now here, why this problem is easy? Because if you see all this fraction, the denominator is same, 16 16 16, same like that. So it's going to be very easy. Let's consider that this is his property, which we are going to divide into 16 equal parts. Okay. Let's divide this into 16 equal parts. Pay attention very carefully. All parts are equal. If they are not looking, consider they are equal. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. So this is his whole property, total property, which he has divided into 16 equal parts. Why we have divided into 16 equal parts? Because in all these fractions given here, the denominator is 16. If the denominator is not 16, means here there would be 16, here there would be something 4, here would be 8, then we have to make the denominator same. Okay. Now see, 3 parts, out of 16, 3 parts he gave to eldest son. I'll use here black pen so that you will understand. Now see, out of 16 equal parts he gave 3 parts. These 3 parts, come and tell. Huh? Asma.
हो क्लास का 16 जज मला मेसेज कर.
देवळगे सर काय अच्छा. सो दीज थ्री पार्ट्स आउट ऑफ 16 इक्वल पार्ट्स थ्री पार्ट्स ही गेव टू हिज एल्डेस्ट सन ओके. देन टू यंगेस्ट सन ही गेव फाइव इक्वल पार्ट्स टू यंगेस्ट सन ही गेव फाइव पार्ट्स आउट ऑफ 16. सो दीज फाइव पार्ट्स 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. 5 equal parts he gave to youngest son. Then second son means middle son he gave 5 parts again. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. These 5 parts out of 16 he gave to second son. Remember, this is property. Now out of 16 how many parts left? 1, 2, 3. 3 parts left. Okay, so this is property of whose? Daughter. This remaining property that was is a property of daughter. So these 3 parts means how many rupees, you know, this is property of daughter, and how many rupees he has given to daughter? 15,000. That means what, you know, these 3 parts represent 15,000. Now 3 parts means 15,000. See, property given to daughter rupees 15,000 means nothing, but if you want to write in the form of fraction, it should be 3 upon 16. 3 parts out of 16. So out of 16, 3 parts means rupees 15,000. So 3 parts means rupees 15,000. Then tell me, each one part out of 16, each one part means how many rupees? 1 part means how many rupees? 3 parts means 15,000. These 3 parts means 15,000 rupees. Then each 1 part means how many rupees? You know, 15,000 divided by 3, that is, if you divide 15 by 3, what you get? 3 5s are 15. Rupees 5,000. So each part represent, each of 16 parts represent 5,000. That means 3 parts means 15,000. Then again 5,000. These 5 parts means 5 5s are 25,000. Likewise, each of 16 part represent 5,000. So total property means how many parts are there? 16 parts. 16 parts, that is 16 into, each part is equal to 5, right? 5,000. So 16 into 5,000, that is 16 5s are 80 and 0, 0, 0, 80,000. So his total property is of 80,000. So he distributed 80,000 rupees among his 4 children. Okay, I hope you understood this. It's very easy. After this, once this figure is determined, how many parts are left here? 3 parts which are of daughter, and daughter has got 15,000 rupees. That means these 3 parts represent 15,000. So see, I have written here 3 parts is equal to rupees 15,000. So after getting 3 parts, find out for 1 part. 1 part is equal to that 15,000 divided by 3. Okay, so that is 5,000. 1 part means 5,000. 1 part represent 5,000 rupees. So total 16 parts are there. So 16 into 5,000, that is 80,000. So whole property means 80,000 rupees. Understood? Next, pause the video and write this in your notebook. this time the questions will be MCQ type, multiple choice. Four options will be given and you have to choose one of the options. So the shortcut method, whichever method is shortcut, you have to go by that method, okay? So this is the shortcut I am showing you. Next, question number 36. See question number 36. The total annual income of a farm is rupees 63,000. Sadhu got 1/3 of the income. Yadu got 1 upon 7 of the income. And Dadu got the rest. Rest means remaining. Find the value of share of each. Means three farmers we can say Sadhu, Yadu and Dadu. There are three farmers. Sadhu, Yadu and Dadu. Okay. Now see, what is Sadhu's income? 1/3. One part out of three. Yadu's income is 1/7. Then what is Dadu's income? That we have to find. Here see, total income is given. Total income means what? Income means what? Income means, see, these three are farmers. They planted something, crop, and they after getting that crop, they sold that, and whatever money they got after selling, that is their income. So total income they got from that farm is rupees 63,000. Okay, 63,000. So out of 63,000, what is the Sadhu's share? 1/3. Means if you divided that total income into three equal parts, he get one part. Yadu's income is 1/7. That means if it is divided into seven equal parts, one part out of seven is Yadu's income, Yadu's share. And remaining is Dadu's share. So, what is Dadu's share or Dadu's income? That we have to find, okay? So, what to do here, you know? First, we will make denominator same. This is 3, this is 7. If this 3 is in, the 7 is in table of 3, then it's very easy to make denominator same. But now see, 3 and 7 are not in any other table, okay? So, what we have to do? We have to find LCM of 3 and 7 and we have to make denominator equal to that LCM. Okay. So, see here LCM of 3 and 7 is. Now, 7 is prime number, 3 also prime number. So, their LCM means their multiplication. 3 7 is 21. So, what we will do? We will make denominator equal to 21. So, here 1/3. That is 1, to make here 3 into, to convert this 3 into 21, we need to multiply 3 by 7, okay? That is 7 1 is 7, 3 7 is 21. Then Yadu, it is 1/7, that is 7 into 3, 7 3 is 21. So 3 1 is 3 upon 21. Now we have both share with the same denominator, 21, 21. So, what we are going to do, this total income, that is 63, we will divide into 21 equal parts. 63,000, we will divide into 21 equal parts, okay? That means what? We will divide this by 21. So, each part is equal to find each part, we will divide this total income, that is rupees 63,000, by, your total parts are 21, okay? 21. So that we will get income in each part. So 63,000 divided by 21. 21 1 is 21, 21 2 is 42, 21 3 is 63. 0, 0, 0. 3,000. So each part means rupees 3,000. Okay? Now see here. Sadhu got 7 out of 21. Sadhu got 7 parts. That is, 1 part means rupees 3000. So 7 part means 7 into rupees 3000. 7, 3 sevens are 21,000. So Sadhu's income is 21,000. Then Yadu got 3 parts out of 21. That is 3 parts, we can say. So 3 parts, 1 part means 3000. So 3 parts means 3 into 3000. Rupees 3000. So 3 threes are 9. So Yadu got 9000. Okay, rupees 9000. And remaining income is of Dadu. So Dadu got remaining parts. So see here, 7 parts and 3 parts, total 10 parts. 10 parts are given to Sadhu and Yadu. Then out of 21, how many parts left? 11 parts. So Dadu's share is 11 parts. That is 11 into 3000. 11 into rupees 3000. So 11 threes are 33 and 1000. So Dadu got how many rupees? 33,000, or 33,000 is Dadu's share. See, 21,000 plus 9,000 plus 33,000, total 63,000. Okay, how we have found? First we made denominator same. We got for that we found LCM of 3 and 7, that is 21. So we may convert denominator into 21, and accordingly the numerator is changed. Okay, so Sadhu share out of 21, 7 parts. Yadu share out of 21, 3 parts. Okay, so before that, each part represent how much rupees, that we have found. We know total income is given 63,000. So each part is equal to 63,000 divided by 21. Its total parts are 21. So total income divided by total parts, that is, and we got 3000. That means what? One part represent 3000. Now Sadhu's parts are 7 out of 21. So 7 parts means 7 into 3000, that is 21,000. Yadu's parts are 3 parts. So 3 into 3000, that is 9000. And remaining parts are of Dadu's. So this 7 and 3, 10 parts, Sadhu and Yadu. And remaining parts, that is 11, 21 minus 10, 11. 11 parts are of Dadu's. So 11 parts means 11 into 3000, 33,000 rupees. Okay. So this is our answer, Dadu's share. Okay. So today we have solved problem number 32 to 36. There are three more problems, 37, 38 and 39. Try to solve by yourself in this method. Okay. Try to solve by yourself. If not possible, I'll show you. Okay, so thank you for today and have a nice day.